During the Vietnam War, a small group of American women came here to Vietnam with the Red Cross on a program known as the Donut Dollies. My mom was one of them. Still, 50 years later almost, very few people have ever heard of them. So we want to bring my mom and her friend Mary back to Vietnam and explore why they came and what they did. We're going to make a documentary about that and share their story with the world. If you can join us and help out, that'd be great.
I'm Dorset, and in 1968, after I graduated from college, I went to Vietnam as a donut dolly. And now, 40 years later, I'd like to share my story.
Their job was very meaningful. It was awful big morale booster. They deserve being remembered for what they did because they were volunteers. They didn't have to come here.
The general said, I will let one of my chopper pilots take you to as many fire bases as you can get to cheer up the men. And what we did is we landed and I gave out the little Red Cross teddy bags where it had little stuff in it. And they sat on my lap and they told me what they wanted for Christmas. Some of which I can repeat and some of which I can't.
She was a round-eyed, brown-eyed, very jolly donut dolly. All the way USA, lovely little donut dolly. Very merry, not contrary, charming little donut dolly. Sure looks great to me.
Woo! That was pretty fun.
Those girls like your mother, and they were girls, they'd had much more fun in the States. Or Japan. But they came here for a reason.
They would always send me to the hospitals. Because that's a very hard aspect of our job, was to see the guys, you know, and they were without limbs or, you know, burned. That was kind of hard. You know, you see the reality of war.
You stand on that place that had such an intense feeling for you in the past, and you get a feeling that starts in your feet and just takes over your whole body. You know you've been there before.
We've come here to Nha Trang, Vietnam, where my mom was stationed for the Donut Dollies and the Red Cross almost 50 years ago. It was a lot different than it is now, but her villa, the place where she was stationed, was somewhere right around here. Here in Tuy Hoa, my mom probably walked along this beach and then went back over to the airbase where she was stationed. She was there for about 5 months. Some of the buildings are still here. We're gonna check it out now, and we're gonna bring her back in a few months so she can see for herself what's the same and what's changed.
This is me in Tuy Hoa on the South China Sea.
Pretty hotsy-totsy, huh?
I remember that day as if it were the other day. Here are some of my treasures, ruined and destroyed.
This is my sayonara book. A bunch of donut dollies made for me